up guys, it's Michael from Calisthenics Family, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to fix your banana handstand and how to get your straight handstand. So let's do this. So welcome to the video, and it has been a while that I did a instructional video. As you have seen in the last videos, Yannick did all the instructional videos, but I'm slightly getting better and getting back to my old level. I recently got released from my arm cast, and now I'm building up my strength again, and I'm also able to do instructional videos. So I'm really motivated and excited to do this finally. So in this video guys, I'm gonna tell you how to fix your banana handstand and how to get a straight handstand. This was actually a request from someone that asked us to make a video about that, because we always ask you guys at the end of the video what kind of videos you want to see. So that is what we're doing today. But before I get into this video, I want to make a small announcement. Because as you might remember, we did a 30-day fat burn challenge in which people could sign up for and participate to work out 30 days in a row with our new 30-day fat burn program, and also can win some epic prizes. And now 30 days later, the challenge is done and we got a winner. So we want to announce the winner, and the winner of the 30-day fat burn challenge from last month is Maurice ten Hopen. In total, he lost 5 kg in 25 days with our program and following the diet plan that comes with the 30-day fat burn program. So as you can see in the photos right here, he did a really, really great job. So we are really proud of him, and that's why he won the number one prize of 100 euro in cash. So that's it about this challenge guys, and we're also going to announce the new challenge at the end of this video. So make sure to keep watching. But for now, let's get into this video guys. So how to move from a banana handstand into a straight handstand. And I want to discuss two really important things. And the first thing is the core. And one thing that is very important is the posterior pelvic tilt. Because if you want to move from a banana handstand towards a straight handstand, you basically need to get control of your upper body and lower body. Because this part needs to connect, otherwise you will get into that banana handstand. So one like trick or tip that we always give to people that we are training, like here at the park, on how to get a sense of how to control this area is this slide example. So once you're in a banana handstand, you basically are having this move, right? So it's your back is really arched like this, but you need to get it straight and aligned and controlled. So what you want to do, just follow me with this slide example. So just stand like this and now move like this. Your core is not controlled, not activated, it's just loose, and you can move like this. And now you can see that you can arch your back like this. But now I'm gonna show you a really important trick. So basically you have to do three things to create posterior pelvic tilt. And the first one is pull your belly in. Then secondly, activate your core, like you have to squeeze them really, really hard, and also squeeze your glutes together and bring your hips in front of you, and also activate your legs. And now squeeze as hard as you can, like really hard, and now try to go back to that arch position again. So, and also activate at the same time. You will notice that you can't move to an arch position because you are really activating everything, like this whole area together. And that is exactly what you need to do in the handstand when you move from banana towards straight handstand. So I will show you in the handstand position. So now it just loops. Squeezing everything together. But I can imagine that if you're gonna try this in the air, that you won't make it, because it's hard to move to this position. So there are a few exercises for the core to activate posterior pelvic tilt and to get control of your upper body and lower body. So the first exercise will be the hollow body hold, and this is one of the most important exercises for the handstand, but also for all other static exercises that you can think of. So I will demonstrate it for you guys. So you gotta lay down on the floor and basically put your legs in the air and also your arms in the air, just like this, and hold this and try to hold this for at least 1 minute, for example. And one of the most common mistakes is that people are going to arch the back when doing this exercise. But that is exactly what you don't want, because we are trying to move from an arch back handstand to a straight handstand. So you want to make sure that your lower back is always in contact with the ground. So I will demonstrate the wrong way. It's like this. And now I can put my hand right here. And the good way is like this. So the same rule applies. You gotta squeeze your core, activate your glutes, and like squeeze everything together. So this whole area will be like connected. All right, so that is the first exercise to get better control of your core. And then the second exercise is like the other way around. It's called the Superman hold. So it looks like this. I'm gonna lay down on the floor, and also the same thing, arms in the air and legs in the air. And you want to make sure that your quads are also in the air. So a big mistake is to do it like this and only have your feet off the ground. But you want to make sure that you're laying down on your hips only and your abs. And also guys, also with this exercise, a very big mistake is also to arch your back with this exercise. That's also a mistake that people make very often. So with this exercise, you want to make sure that your legs and arms and like this whole area is completely straight and controlled. So I will show you the wrong way. It's like this, arching. And now the better way is to do it like this. It's maybe hard to see, but the difference is that you gotta squeeze your glutes and your abs, like, so it won't arch. All right guys, so these two exercises are really good to get like a stronger core and to connect this whole area. But I have one other exercise which is also really good, and the difference with the previous exercise and this exercise is that with the previous exercises you are laying on the floor with your hips or your glutes. But in the handstand position, you are obviously in the air, so you are not laying on something. And so you also gotta work on like a plank position, but in the pelvic tilt plank position. I don't know if there's a name for this exercise, but it works really well to get control of this area. I will demonstrate it. So you're gonna lay down like this, and now instead of doing this, you're gonna put your glutes in the air, but now you can see that my back is arched, and that is what we don't want. So now you're gonna like squeeze your glutes together and also your core and lower back and hold this. All right, so once again, you're gonna put your hips in the air and glutes in the air. Now it's arched, and from here you want to move to here, and my hips are off the ground. So from here to here, there to here. And then you can either hold the exercise in like the pelvic tilt plank position for like 1 minute, and you will feel the burn, and it maybe looks quite simple, but it's actually pretty hard if you're gonna hold this for like 1 minute. Or you can do dynamics, like moving from the arch back towards the straight plank position with pelvic tilt, so you will get a better sense of the dynamic move that you'll need to take when you're doing the handstand, banana handstand towards straight handstand. All right, guys, so that was all about the core, the abs, and like this whole area. And now we're moving on to the second part, and that is like core dynamics in the handstand position and also shoulder mobility. Because if you're only going to do the core exercise that I just did, then you will improve your core strength, but you also need to work in the exact same movement in the handstand position. So one really good exercise is to do this on like the handstand on the wall and do this arched back to a straight handstand. So from here, arch back to straight. So you're gonna do a wall handstand and moving from arch to straight. And first, the first tip is that you wanna do it really close towards the wall. Otherwise, you won't be able to go from arch to straight. So like this, this is arched. And now, straight. Arched, and do the exact same thing like I said with the core exercises. So pelvic tilt, straight. So with this exercise you can clearly see that I'm implementing this movement from arched to straight, pelvic tilt. And one other thing that you see is that I'm leaning forward a little bit when I'm in the arched position. So with this exercise, it's not only about the core and this dynamic movement, but also your shoulder mobility. Because in the banana handstand, you're leaning a little bit forward, and that's because you're not like mobile enough in your shoulders, so you gotta open up your shoulders. So I will demonstrate it again, and watch carefully to my shoulders. So banana handstand, like this, and you see that my shoulders are forward and not open. But if you want to get in a straight handstand, your shoulders into the ground, like this. Push. From here, push. So it's like a straight arm pusher. Push. So with this example, you can clearly see it's also really important to work on your shoulder mobility and opening your shoulders. And I'm basically doing a scapula handstand push-up, but you can also work on opening the shoulders by doing just regular scapula push-ups, just like this. From here, and push with straight arms. Maybe lean a little bit forward, like you're doing in an arched handstand. And push. All right, guys, so these were basically all the exercises. So all the core exercises and shoulder exercises to work on a straight handstand. So I hope you guys like this video. And like I said in the beginning, I wanna do a announcement because we're going to do a new 30-day fat burn challenge starting from the 1st of August. So that is on Thursday. And what is the challenge? You basically can participate by joining our 30-day fat burn program. And until Thursday, we have a 25% discount for the program. And in the beginning of the video, we showed you the winner of the previous challenge. He lost 5 kg in 25 days of the program. And he also made some gains. So this program is purely focused on losing fat and also just getting overall fitter and also building a little bit more muscle. So if you want to join this challenge, and also of course with this challenge we have some epic prizes. The number one will get a 100 euro cash prize, the number two will get a 100 euro my protein coupon, and the number three will get a 50 euro my protein coupon. So if you want to join this challenge, guys, then make sure to check the link down in the description for the program and for all the information. All right, guys, so that's it about this video. I really hope that you like this video and that you can work on your handstand, on your straight handstand. And this was a request from someone. So if you want to see a video about something that you want to work on, please let us know in the comments, and then we might do a video about that in the future. So that's it, guys. Don't forget to like this video, and also don't forget to subscribe for more videos, and we catch you in the next video. Peace out, guys.